Yep, and then make sure it's on the black knight.
Time I'm gonna say Impact, how y'all feel it. You're gonna scream like you've never screamed before, like you are ready for 2024. That rhymed. Impact, how y'all feel it? Man, what a year, huh? Can you believe 2023 has come to an end? We are about to embark on a brand new year, brand new experiences. Listen, we're starting fresh. Who's ready? Y'all are ready. Y'all better get ready. I don't know if you're ready. Well, hey, I just want to take a second and say, hey, we're so glad that you came out the first time ever, not at the McGlynn Middle School, at the Chevalier Theater. Come on now, that's a big deal, y'all. We're about to pray so loud that all of Medford's going to hear us. Amen? Amen? Amen. Hey, we're on my fam. Where's my Impact fam at? Give me a nice little shout. I'm just getting you guys warmed up. If this is your first Impact event ever, give me a nice little shout. Okay, okay. Hey, we're so glad that you're here, and we want to make sure that before you leave today, all of you in this room, we've got a lot of great things happening in January 2024, which is like in a couple hours, and I want to make sure you don't miss it, so stay with me for a second. I know y'all are like, let's get ready to worship, I'm ready to go. I don't want you to miss this, okay? Here we go. Y'all ready? If you're ready, say yup. Here we go. January, new sermon series. I need y'all to come into the building. But before we talk about all the things in January, for all of you in this room, I skipped a step. We got our first event, January, I think it's our first one, January 13th. It's a Saturday. Oh, I can see your pretty faces. It's a Saturday. We have our Connect breakfast. So all y'all who just yelled, hey, this is my first Impact event, I'm inviting you to your second, your third Impact event. It's our Connect breakfast. We would love for you to join our family if you do not already have a church home. Hey, we'd love to have you, and we've got a lot of great stuff going on. And so January 13th, we are having a wonderful breakfast that you are invited to. If you've never been to our Connect breakfast, come through. You can let us know that you're coming. Hey, look, we got a QR code. Maybe not up there, but right there we do. Click that. Let us know that you're coming. We would love to meet you, get to hear your story, and help get you to know who we are at Impact. It is one thing you do not want to miss. Start your year off right. Get plugged in. Amen? Okay. Y'all out there? Who drank a coffee? Who drank a Red Bull? Somebody is ready to go. Hey, we got more in January. Don't just end here. On next Sunday, we are starting our new sermon series. And in the month of January, every single Sunday, we do a recommitment prayer in our services. And we start off the first Sunday of the year doing a recommitment prayer for marriages. So if you're married up in the house, get yourself there. Recommit yourself for 2024. You and your spouse is going to be the best year ever. Ever. Then we're going to pray for singles the next week. We're going to pray for kiddos, and then I forget the last one, businesses, the fourth week. But y'all, we are recommitting, we are giving 2024 to God and letting Him take control and lead us through the whole year. So you do not want to miss January, y'all. Nudge your neighbor, say, neighbor, do not miss January. Okay? Y'all, recommitment Sunday, we got Connect Breakfast. We got iGroups that are starting up. Okay, you're going to hear a little more about that later. And last but not least, drum roll. Thanks. 21 days of fasting and prayer this year, y'all. Come on now. We are continuing throughout the whole year fasting and praying, but we are going back to praying and fasting the month of January for 21 days. We're going to talk about that a little more today. But y'all, I hope that you're hearing all of this and you're getting amped. 2024 is going to be the best year yet. I don't know what you came in here tonight feeling heavy with, a big man, it was another bad year. I don't know what's this next year going to hold. God is going to blow your mind. And what an opportunity to start it here worshiping. Who's excited? Nah, y'all ain't ready. I need you to get on your feet. Come on, get on your feet. And we're just going to do a 30-second praise break and just shout and get excited and lay the foundation. Because y'all, who is ready for the new year, 2024? Come on, let me hear you. All right. Hey, stay on your feet. We're going to start off, we're going to set the tone with prayer. And while, before he even comes out to lead us in prayer, I want you to nudge your neighbor and say, neighbor, you better get ready. Because God's about to blow your mind.
Yeah! What's up, Impact family? It's about that time. So excited, so grateful. 2023 was an incredible year, a challenging year, a faithful year. Praise God, we are all here to be able to cross over into the new year. Before I pray, I want to read a scripture.
up your hands, O you gates, and be lifted up, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord, strong and mighty, the Lord, mighty in battle. Lift up your hands, O you gates, lift up, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. Father God, I thank you for your faithfulness. I thank you for your covering. I thank you for your love, for your grace, for your mercy. Holy Spirit, we invite you in this place. Have your way. Have your way, God, as we cross over from 2023 into 2024, for the promises that you have for us, the transformation that awaits for us. We thank you, God, for your faithfulness and the praise you demand, for all the blessings, all your favors, your healing, Lord, your deliverance, Lord, your favor, oh God. We thank you. We thank you in this place, and we worship you, Jesus, for your love and your sacrifices, by your power, by your power, by your stripes, and we're healed, by your blood. We thank you, we love you, Lord, in your name, amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, keep celebrating, keep celebrating. I don't know about you, but I came to get my miracle. I don't know about you, but I'm saying that in the name of Jesus, addiction is broken. In the name of Jesus, my family is set free. In the name of Jesus, it starts with me. Hallelujah. I was reading in James today, and it spoke about how the tongue is so small, yet it has the power to declare and make the body move. So I know, you're not used to shouting, you're not used to saying what's inside, but I need you to open up your mouth. Jehovah Jireh's in the room, Emmanuel is in the room, God is for you, and if God is for you, nothing can be against you. And guess what? Addiction, alcoholism, it runs in my family, it ain't just me. You know what? People in my family are addicted to marijuana. It ends with me. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. What am I trying to say? Shout out to God with a voice of triumph. Shout out to God like you're already free. Because guess what? Where the Spirit of the Lord is. You're where the Spirit of the Lord is. There is freedom. There is freedom. And guess what? He's in the room. He's in the room. So sing today. Worship today. Like you are going into 2024 with the victory in your hand. Because guess what? Spoiler. You're already victorious. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
For what he has done and what he is about to do in your life in 2024. Have you guys come to worship tonight? Have you guys come to experience miraculous things tonight? Let's get this thing going. Our God is good. Let's give him a new praise. Here we go. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. 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 I praise the Lord, sure. Praise the Lord. I praise the Lord, not the bird. Praise the Lord, surrounding. Just praise is the water. My enemies drown. You guys know this one. Here we go. This morning as I'm breathing, I hear the reason to praise. I'll
Thank you.
churches cry out. Jesus, thy
Holy are you, Lord. Thank you. What? I'm gonna go to the hospital. I don't know if you've ever wondered this, but have you ever thought to yourself, I wish somebody would come and just tell me everything's going to be all right. I mean, imagine if you knew somebody whose word was really accurate. Maybe they could predict the future, and they had a reputation of being accurate, and they said to you, you know, I just know everything's going to be all right. Wouldn't that feel so good? But people are not reliable. But I want you to know that God Almighty has said that in His word to you. You don't need to wait for someone to come to you and tell you everything's going to be okay. You don't need to wait for that doctor to come and tell you everything's going to be okay. Because guess what? All you got to do is open the Word and look at it. And God already told you everything is going to be all right. He's got it all worked out. And we want to build our faith tonight, together as we gather in this place. And I'm going to pray with you, and we're going to just agree that God will give us faith to believe in this new year for the impossible. And Jesus said in Matthew 17, I tell you the truth, if you have faith as small as a mustard seed, and it's the smallest seed, if you have faith as small as a mustard seed, you can say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move. And nothing will be impossible for you. Nothing will be impossible for you. See, you've got to get the faith in you to believe that all things are possible in God. Amen. So let's just begin to pray right now. The band's going to help us, and we're just going to seek the presence of God and ask for faith. Come on, right now, just begin to lift your voice. Say, Father, I need more faith. I need faith just to believe and trust you this year, that everything's going to be all right because that's what you told me in your word. I don't have to wait for somebody to tell me because you already promised. You already promised everything's going to be all right. You are the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning, the end, the first, the last. You see the end from the beginning. And so tonight we believe, we put our faith in you. Even if it's as faith as small as a mustard seed, we put it in you. Our hope is in you, God. Some trust in chariots and some in horses. Or you might say today, some trust in armies and some trust in militaries. But we trust in the name of the Lord our God. They are brought to their knees and fall, but we rise up and stand firm. Come on, put your hands together and believe. Believe. Say, Lord, help my unbelief. Lord, help my unbelief. I believe. I believe for great things. Come on. I believe for great things this year. I'm trusting in you. I know you're going to do it. I know you're going to do it. I believe it. Oh, come on, give him a clap offering of praise like it's already done. It's already done. Yeah. Yeah. Amen. Amen.
Right here in your presence. We humble ourselves. Children have come to worship you in Jesus' name. You guys ready for this one? His name is Adonai. It's real simple. Your children have come to worship you. Holy, holy.
To worship you. God in advance for what we see him giving us. This is how I fight about that. Yeah. Thank you. sent us home. 24 hours later, my daughter Marin is in the audience over there. She calls me, and I knew it was going to be this again. It was an emergency and an ambulance this time. And over 45 minutes of just bleeding out. And of course, in that moment, I just realized, you know, God used me for many miracles in people's lives. But in this moment, I realized that God was saying to me, there's an order I have, and it goes down through the pastor and the elders of the church. And I just felt like, okay, Lord, you know what? Because what can I do for her? She's my daughter, and my heart is, you know, is racing out. So I thought of the prayer request through Impact Church, and I couldn't get through, but I didn't give up. And I Googled and found this number. I called that number. Pastor Zenzo answered the phone. Hallelujah. Praise God. So I spent a couple of minutes sharing with him what happened. And obviously we needed prayer, so he had me pull my vehicle over, and we prayed together. I don't know how long that was. And then after he encouraged me in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, he just felt himself that God was going to answer that prayer and stop that nose from bleeding. What I have right here is a timeline from the time that I called him to the time I called my son in that ambulance. And after we were done praying, my son said, Dad, her nose suddenly stopped bleeding.
Somebody praise! Yeah. Come on, somebody praise Jesus in this room. Jesus is about to do it again. One of the spirits we're breaking tonight is a spirit of unbelief. When you hear a testimony like that, and I told this brother, I said, check your watch right now. It's 2:43, 2:45. Check with them the time that bleeding stopped. And it was exactly that time. And the timeline is here. That is Jehovah. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Come on, can somebody break the spirit of unbelief in this room and even celebrate Jesus?
Hallelujah.
I got two more for you. Let's go to the next testimony here of the goodness of God. Would you turn to your neighbor and just tell them, God is at work in this place.
Hi, my name is Vanessa, and I wanted to share a little bit of my story of how I came to Hunger Nights in November. I went there because I had been having some issues in the past with thoughts of suicide and depression, and I actually had been having a series of incidents that started in the spring where I was having seizures, and I just really needed something to hold on to and to have faith in God. And back in the spring when I was having some issues and thoughts of suicide and having those seizures, I turned to God and I was reading scripture verses, and the only thing that got me through it was God. And I was able to then beginning of July go seizure free, so I'm just about to be 6 months seizure free, starting actually being tomorrow. And coming to Hunger Nights, I was able to kind of renounce any underlying issues that I had and feel free from depression. And I actually just feel so much freer and lighter since I've come to Hunger Nights. I just am really thankful in God, and this whole experience has just been amazing, and I just feel so free and on fire for Jesus.
Vanessa is free. Come on, I need a few people in this room to celebrate like that's your, I need some like that's your niece. Come on. Come on, let's celebrate a little more in this house. Jesus is still rebuking demons and casting out demons. In Jesus' name, come on, another 60 seconds, everything in the music. Let's worship Jesus. Let's give praise to Jesus. Father, do it again tonight in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. You guys got room for one more? Let's go to the next video. Stretch your hands. We give you praise, Jesus. For your reason, we'll know you as the God who healed her ear. So we give you praise, Jesus, for the beautiful work you're doing.
Beforehand, I couldn't hear conversations. I would always have to ask someone to repeat themselves. Whereas now, I don't have to do that anymore. I can clearly hear what people are saying and doing. And just like seeing that shift and seeing how long I've suffered with it. It's like seeing how far, like just that one prayer, just that one cry out for God. And just seeing his faithfulness in it through it all. It's just showing like he's always there. Like even when we feel like we don't need it, God knows and he's going to make a way for it to happen. Especially when you're just praying for someone else. And I can also say, on behalf of my mom, she also got healed where she doesn't feel that pain that she felt anymore.
Come on, let's rise. Somebody shout and celebrate. Come on. I'm going to shout 1, 2, 3. And if you believe that our Jesus still opens deaf ears, I don't know about you, Jesus, but my Jesus still opens deaf ears. The Jesus of Boston still opens deaf ears. Everybody rising, come on, let's just lift up a shout of praise in this place. Hallelujah. If you're able to, if you can stand, if you're able to, just rise up. Let's all rise together if you're able to. Hallelujah. If you're in this place and you're in desperate need of a miracle, you believe in God for a miracle, or you have a family member that's been given a death sentence, doctors have told them, we're done here. If you have a friend that's in desperate need of a miracle, we believe that our Jesus still opens deaf ears. But you shout hallelujah. That's our Jesus. He's a healer. He still delivers people from the spirit of suicide. Because he is the way, the truth, and the life. Come on, I sense a faith in this room tonight to believe God for the impossible. Amen. This is Boston. God's doing a new thing in Boston. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I'm going to shout 1, 2, 3 if that's you. You believe in God for a miracle. You know someone you want to stand in their place to believe God for miracles. So as I shout 3, I want you to just, we don't have enough room here, but you can come up as a point of contact. And leaders, whoever's a leader among us here, just go around and begin to lay hands. Let's believe God for a miracle. Amen. That friend of mine who's believing God for a brand new heart, I want them to come as well to find that Jesus is going to heal you tonight in Jesus' name. Amen. Can we just put our hands together and celebrate them and encourage them as they come to the front? Come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We give you praise, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. The presence of Jesus in this room. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. If you're in the balcony, you don't have to come down here. But you can just walk to the front right there and just stand at the front right there. By the way, thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Now we're going to do this together. Would you just stretch your hands towards this and begin to pray. Pray like this is your uncle. Pray like it's your mother. Pray like it's your father. Pray like it's your family member. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Jesus, we love you, Lord. We worship you, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. We worship you, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. We worship you, Jesus. We love you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Jesus Christ, Son of David. Son of David. Come on, Boston, I need you to pray. Boston, I need you to pray. Somebody stand in the gap. Boston, I need you to pray. Jesus Christ. If you don't know how to say, just shout, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. Oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We rebuke you, spirit of infirmity. You foul spirit of infirmity. We command you to go now in Jesus' name. Set God's people free. Set God's people free, we pray. In the name of Jesus, set God's people free, we pray. We rebuke you, foul spirit of infirmity. You foul spirit of sickness and disease. We command you to go now in the name of Jesus. We command you to go now in the name of Jesus. Father, we plead the blood, the blood, the blood, the blood, the blood, the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus that never loses its power. We release the work of the blood of Jesus, the finished work of the cross. We release the finished work of the cross now in Jesus' name. And devil, we command you, take your hands off God's people in Jesus' name and set them free. Devil, we command you, take your hands off of God's people and set them free. Devil, we command you, take your hands off of God's people and set them free. We release the blood, the blood, the blood, the blood, the finished work of the cross now in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, we praise you and we celebrate you for the healings. In Jesus' name we pray. Come on, we all say together, amen and amen. Boston, I need you to shout like God just healed your mother. I need you to shout like God just healed your uncle. I need you to shout like God just healed your sister. I need you to shout. Now, Boston, that was 50%. We're going to go wild tonight. Can we go crazy in Boston? One more time, we're going to take that thing to a 10. I need you to praise God like God just healed your mother. I need you to praise God like God just healed your father. Come on, I need you to
has come for me. Hope has come for you. And hope is here. His name is Jesus. Thank you.
stay safe. Jesus, declare all hell. Oh,
By faith, God's been good to me in 2023, and I believe He's going to do even greater. the car for about 3 years. He didn't say anything else, he just... And then he asked me this question. He said, are you ever planning on setting it up? And I'm thinking, the devil is a liar. This guy better get off my car. And then he asked me another question I thought was interesting. He said, is this how you do everything in your life? And I thought about that. And as I was believing God for 2024 and asking God in fasting and prayer, God, what is the theme for 2024? What do you desire to do with your people? And I was asking the Lord, what's the new theme you have for us? What is the new theme, God, that you have for Impact Church? And the Lord said to me, Zenzo, I'm going to do some new things. I'm going to do some amazing things in 2024. Anybody expecting some amazing things in 2024? The Lord said, I'm going to do some amazing things in 2024. But I want you to know this, your greatest blessings are not going to come from all the new things. I'm going to do some new things and they're going to bless you. But he said, but the greatest blessings are not going to come from all the new things. He says, the greatest blessings are going to come as I teach you to maximize the blessings that I've already given you. Or if you haven't clapped yet tonight, you need to clap right here. The greatest blessings, you already have them right now. God's already blessed you. And he said, I'm going to teach you how to maximize. Because I discovered that I was using my car at only 50%. I was using my car at only 60%. And so the Lord spoke to me. And I want to declare this. And I want you to shout like you already see what God's about to do. And 2024 is the year to maximize. Come on, somebody shout, it's the year to maximize. Come on, yeah, you already have some blessings that God gave you in 2023. And in 2024, God's going to maximize every blessing that he has given you. I need someone to celebrate God in advance for the spirit of maximizing what he has already given you. We're going to learn how to steward. We're going to learn how to steward. He asked me, he said, is this how you do everything in your life? You have a GPS in your car, but you're not using it. You're driving around holding onto a phone. And the Lord said, tell my people in 2024, you're going to be blessed, not because of all the new things God's going to give you. He's already blessed you with so many things. He's going to open your eyes and you're going to begin to maximize on the blessings that God has already given you. And you just say something to your neighbor, just tell them 2024 is the year to maximize. Talk to that other neighbor, 2024 is the year to maximize. Jackson, would you come up here in the blankets? Jackson, please come up here in the blankets. So in this scripture here, it says, we all, with unveiled face, beholding us in a mirror, the glory of the Lord. Jackson, is what's going on here? You can just leave this here. And I want you to take some notes. We all, with unveiled face, beholding us in a mirror, the glory of the Lord, are being transformed into the same image from glory to glory. Just as by the Spirit of the Lord. I grab this for my children. Jackson, I'm sorry, man. This is how some of us were in 2023. Veils. Somebody say veils. I need you to prophesy over somebody and don't play with me. Tell them the veils are coming off. No more veils. No more veils. The second veil. Here's the third veil. Jackson, you're doing good in there. stop some of us from moving in 2023. Somebody shout veils. Somebody shout no more veils. There were five veils that God spoke to the children of Israel, the veils that they had. I want to take you to 1 Corinthians 10, verse 16. 6 to 10. It says, now these things became our examples to the intent that we should not lust after evil things, as they also lust. The first veil is the spirit of lust. Do not become idolaters, as some of them were. As it is written, the people sat down to eat and drink and rose up to play. Idols is number two. The third veil, it says, no, let us commit sexual immorality, as some of them did. And in one day, 23,000 fell. Sexual morality. No, let us tempt Christ, as some of them also tempted and were destroyed by serpents. That's a spirit of rebellion. Number four, the fourth veil is a spirit of rebellion. Number five, no, complain, as some of them complained and were destroyed by the destroyer. The fifth veil is a spirit of ungratefulness. It's a fifth spirit of complaining. Stay right there, buddy. You're doing good. Let's look back. Number one, the veil of lust. Somebody say lust. You're going to see this in 2024. There's an increase of the spirit of lust. Uncontrolled desires. We've seen it in 2023. We're going to continue to see it in 2024. But it will not be the same for you, because God is removing the veils. We've seen church people who are controlled by careers, church people who are controlled by the spirit of success and materialism, lust, becomes a veil. The second veil is the veil of idols. The third veil is the veil of sexual morality. And we don't preach like this anymore, but can I just declare tonight, I come as a prophet. Any sex outside of marriage is a sin. Somebody shout hallelujah. Let's get back to purity in Jesus' name. One of the veils that's been removed in our generation is the veil of pornography. Oh, can I be a prophet tonight and declare this? There are veils among men, even among women. The veil of sexual morality. Number four, the veil of rebellion. Rebellion is a spirit of witchcraft. And there's a veil of witchcraft, a spirit of rebellion. The truth is, there's a boom and a rising of prophetic movements, but a lot of the prophetic movements that are rising are doubling in black magic. That's why, as the church, we pray for the sick, because the world is hungry for power. They need to find power in the house of God. Oh, come on, I'm praying in the name of Jesus. One of the veils that the enemy has placed upon us is to refuse walking in the power of God and believing and stretching out in faith. And I'm declaring upon Boston that the spirit of faith, signs and wonders, and the power of God is returning back to our churches in Jesus' name. Somebody say amen. There's a young generation that's running to the occult because they're looking for power. They want to see a God that opens deaf ears. And a part of witchcraft is a spirit of not being submitted. Most of the times people you hear talking about church hurt, they're just people operating in a spirit of rebellion. A spirit that doesn't know how to submit to anyone or anything. And God's doing a new thing. Here's something that's going to happen in 2024. We've seen a boom of these podcasters on YouTube preaching the gospel. Now, can I speak over this tonight? There's a generation of a people that are walking out of the church because of a lack of submission, and their church becomes the podcasters. Men and women who've not been ordained, infidels in the kingdom, and people are feeding from these people. Come on, get back to reading your Bible in Jesus' name. Somebody shout hallelujah. Get back to reading your Bible in the name of Jesus. I know this sounds a little old school tonight, but there's a veil of witchcraft and rebellion, and it brings anxiety and pain and the spirit of suicide. But God is bringing repentance again back to the house of God. And the final veil is a veil of entitlement. There's an ungrateful spirit. It's a generation of people that complain, people that feel entitled. We're raising a generation of a people that complain all the time. But such is a generation that seeks your face, O God of Jacob. God is raising up a generation that's going to seek his face and worship him again. Would you just lift up your hands and just thank him for his goodness, for his goodness. Father, we thank you for our families. We thank you for the amazing things you've done in our lives. If you can go back to that main scripture, it says, but we all, with unveiled face, beholding as in the mirror, of God are being transformed into the same image from glory to glory, just as by the Spirit of the Lord. Now, impact in 2024, it's the year to maximize. How are you going to maximize? God's going to remove the veils. God will begin to open your eyes and remove the veils. The veils of restriction. The veils of ungratefulness, the veils that have closed your eyes from seeing all that God is doing in your life. Anybody believing God for the veils to be removed in Jesus' name? Come on, I pray for your families in Jesus' name. You're going to come, keep clapping in Jesus' name. Because Jackson here, somebody shout us to remove the veils. Somebody shall take the veils off. Somebody shall take the veils off. Somebody shall take the veils off. You cannot maximize your life when there are veils. Somebody shout, God, remove the veils. God, remove the veils. God, remove the veils. In Jesus' name. Somebody shout, God, remove the veils. Jackson, I need you to jump and celebrate. God, remove the veils. But keep that there. Keep that there. He said, but we, with unveiled face, beholding as in the mirror, glory of God. Let's just say I'm God. I'm not. But let's just say I'm God. When the veil has been removed, you begin to see God. When you begin to see God, you behold as in a mirror. Once you begin to see God without veils, it becomes a mirror. The glory of God becomes a mirror. And you see yourself in your new way, in a way you've never seen yourself before. And this is the version that will maximize. Somebody celebrate Jesus in this place. Once you begin to look at God without the veils, you begin to see yourself in a new way. And this is the version that maximizes. So every eye closed. Father, I pray. In the name of Jesus, that you're removing the veils. Father, reveal the veils. Reveal the veils. Reveal the veils that your people have on their heads. Reveal the veils. Reveal the veils. Would you ask him? Let him reveal the veils that are in your family. Let him reveal the veils that are in your family. The veils. The veils. Reveal the veils. Reveal the veils. Somebody shout 2024 shall it be 2024, the year to maximize. One more time, 2024, the year to maximize. No more limitations, no more veils. Come on, shout it out big, no more limitations, no more veils. In the name of Jesus, I will become all that Jesus wants me to become. In Jesus' name. Come on, 60 more seconds. Somebody just celebrate maximizing. You will maximize. You will become all that Jesus wants you to be. In Jesus' name. Remain standing. I want them to cue the video for Maximize. And then I have an exciting announcement for you guys that we're going to go to. This is the 2 Corinthians 3:18. But we all, with unveiled face, beholding us in a mirror, the glory of the Lord, are being transformed into the same image from glory to glory, just as by the Spirit of the Lord. 2024, the year to maximize our calling from glory to glory, the year to maximize our impact for God, maximizing devotions, maximizing prayer, maximizing reading God's word, maximize the healing, maximize growth spiritually, mentally, and physically, maximize resources, maximize time, maximize gifts and talents, maximize dreams and visions, maximize marriage and family for God, maximize our days and purpose in life. In 2024, our days and lives will not be wasted. not said yes to the call, you may miss it. Now, I have an exciting announcement for you guys. Anybody excited to hear something new that God's doing among us? And then after that, I promise you, we go into the next level in our worship, and we're going to cross over into the new year. God's about to do something powerful in this place. Amen. Now, Impact Church, here's the announcement. In 2024, we are beginning a campaign so that we can build or buy a building for our church. I think they didn't hear me. I said, Impact Church, we're beginning a campaign in 2024 to buy a building. Now, if you don't come to Impact Church, you can still help us celebrate. We're beginning a campaign so we can raise finances to buy a building for our church. Somebody shout hallelujah. Now, this is a nice building. Maybe we need to just buy this building. For another 10 minutes. Now, our vision and impact is so simple. We want to impact you so that you can impact your world. And our mission statement is so simple. Encountering God. Everything we do starts from the presence of God. Encountering God. Empowering people. And impacting lives. We have so many young leaders in our church. In 8 years, God has done such a work. So many thousands saved. But it's because of young leaders that God is raising in the house of God. Because everything for us begins in the presence of God. And then we empower leaders. I don't know about you, but I believe young people can be leaders in God's house. And then impacting lives. We had a desire when we started this church to have a culture of revival, to have a culture of honor. And honor is simply this. Honor is celebrating somebody's strengths without tripping on their weaknesses. Because everybody has a strength. We wanted to see a culture of health. Many people come to Impact Church to find health. Health emotionally, health in their marriages. We wanted to see a culture of miracles, signs, and wonders. Doing that without all the weird and spooky things. Doing it well. Preserving the power of God. Preserving the healing ministry. We also wanted to see a culture of fun. And this is what we say at Impact Church, that fun is serious business. We wanted to see a culture of servanthood. Close to 40% of our house of Impact Church, they serve in God's house. Somebody shout amen. That's why many people have been saved. We wanted to see a culture of excellence. Now, in 8 years, we have seen thousands of people give their lives to Jesus. And in 8 years, people have said, this has been one of the fastest church plants in the history of our region with 4 services. How many people know it's all about souls, souls, souls? It's about depopulating hell and populating heaven in Jesus' name. Somebody shout amen. To God be all the glory. Post-COVID, we've seen 1,000% growth in salvations, 425% growth in baptisms, 667% growth in volunteers, and 325.5% growth in attendance. To Jesus be the praise. Discipled young people to become ministry leaders. In 8 years, we've seen effective teaching of the Word of God. In 8 years, we've seen powerful healing and deliverance ministry. In 8 years, we've seen impact music. Can we just celebrate impact music for a second? We've seen God release them. In 8 years, we've seen effective media ministry. We've preached the gospel on Fox 25. 8 years, we've seen a vibrant servanthood culture. In 8 years, we've seen effective freedom ministries. Can we just celebrate our freedoms team at Impact Church, led by our incredible Pastor Femi? Amen. We've seen an effective
tabernacle season into a temple season where we establish a permanent base, a place where we dispatch and send people to do great things for Jesus. Somebody say amen. Now, we're believing that for many campuses around New England and even the world. So what we believe in God for is just location number one, our permanent base number one, so that it can become a center of sending people into the nations of the earth. It's going to become location number one. Somebody say location number one. Now, I want to give you the name of the campaign that we're going to do. Today is about just sowing seed. I wanted to just sow seed and whet your appetites. And then after this, we're going to go back into worship and believe God for 2024. Acts chapter 17, verse 5 to 7. It says, but the Jews who were not persuaded, becoming envious, took some of the evil men from the marketplace, gathering a mob, set all the city in an uproar, and attacked the house of Jason, and sought to bring them out to the people. But when they did not find them, they dragged Jason and some brethren to the rulers of the city, crying out, these who have turned the world upside down have come here too. These who have turned the world upside down have come here too. Jason has harbored them, and these are all acting contrary to the decrees of Caesar, saying, there's another king, and his name is Jesus. Now, the name that God's given us for this campaign is very radical. We haven't done anything that's not radical in a long time. We are a radical people. In this scripture here, Paul and Silas had left Philippi, and they went to Thessalonica to preach the gospel. They had preached in a jail cell. They had done many great things. But when they got to Thessalonica, there was a mob that went to Jason's house, where they were staying, where they were sleeping. And when they went there, they started crying out and saying, these who have turned the world upside down have come to our city as well. And so the name of our campaign is an upside down campaign, because we're here to declare that there's a new king. We're turning New England cities upside down for Jesus. We are turning New England's cities upside down for Jesus. Somebody shout upside down. Turning cities upside down for Jesus campaign. We're going to go from city to city in New England. We're going to turn them upside down for Jesus by planting churches. Somebody shout amen. Now, the tagline for this campaign is 100% participation. Would you turn to your neighbor and just say, impact, 100% participation. One more time, impact, 100% participation. Now, impact in the next 2 years, 24 months, we're believing God to raise $5 million for our building. Somebody shout amen. I need some church people to help me celebrate the Lord. We're believing God to raise $5 million in this upside down campaign. We're going to have some vision nights. We're going to have some kingdom builders retreats. We're going to have some small groups vision casting. We're going to do some series on Sundays. We're going to have something called a commitment Sunday, where people will make a pledge for what they want to give to the kingdom of God, to build God a house, our base for ministry. This is our base for ministry. And then we're going to have something that's called a celebration Sunday, where you're going to bring the first portions of the pledge that you're going to make. God's going to raise millionaires. Where's the $5 million going to come from? It's going to come from you, because God's going to bless your business. Come on, somebody. God's going to bless your business and allow you to be a part of building the kingdom of God. In fact, would you stand if you can? In Jesus' name. I want you to just hold hands if you can, and let's ask God to allow us to go on this spiritual journey. Amen. We're going to pray, because this is a spiritual journey. How many know this? How many many people know this is not about money. This is about building the kingdom of God. Amen. So we're going to pray and ask God to give us the grace, the strength, the finances, and to speak to us on how we ought to be part of this. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on, lift up the music, and for the next 60 seconds, as the worship team comes back, just begin to pray. Just begin to pray. And if you're coming from another church, if you're coming from another church, just begin to ask God. Just begin to ask God to bless your church as well. Begin to ask God to bless your church with a building, to bless your church with finances. We declare that the kingdom of God in New England will not be resisted. The kingdom of God in New England will not stop because of the lack of finances. Pray. In Jesus' name we pray that you're restoring finances back into the kingdom of God, that we will build the kingdom in New England in Jesus' name. Somebody shout amen and amen. Impact, one more time if you're not tired. Would you just clap your hands and celebrate as the worship team comes to lead us in another time of worship.
Jacob was blessing his sons. If you read this in Genesis, you'll find that he stops at Judah. He stops at Judah. As we all know, the Lion of Judah. And he blesses Judah. And the Son of Man was to go through the line of Judah, down to David, down to Solomon, all the way down to Jesus. King Jesus, establishing his kingdom on earth as it is in heaven. And as we prepare ourselves for 2024, there's this one truth hearts. And as we sing this song, I want you to picture this kingdom established here on earth. And the declaration that we will proclaim for generations and generations to come is this:
our God reigns. Our God reigns forever. Your kingdom reigns. Oh, our God reigns. Our God reigns forever. Your kingdom reigns. Oh, our God reigns. Our God reigns forever. Your kingdom
reigns. Don't just take this moment and begin to pray. Begin to pray over your future. Begin to pray over your family. Begin to pray over your future, your family's future, your healing. Pray for your city. Pray for your loved one's salvation. This is your moment. Just begin to open up your mouth and pray.
Thank you.
Ask him in this place. I crossing into the new year. We declare the enemy has been defeated. We declare the enemy has been defeated. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. The enemy has been defeated. And death cannot hold you down. We gotta make your praises now. The enemy has been defeated. And death cannot hold you down.
We're gonna lift our voice in victory. Gonna make your
praise. Sing it out loud. The enemy's been defeated.
Somebody shout 2024, the year to maximize. Thank you. Thank you.
about tomorrow. For the God who cares for the sparrows cares for me. My God never fails. So how could I fail? Never, never. Never, never. Failure is not part of my portion. For I was born into abundance. I am part of the kingdom of abundance. Serving a God of abundance. Therefore, I walk in abundance. And I possess the abundance mentality. I am a royal ambassador of the kingdom of God. Whatever I bind on earth is bound in heaven. Whatever I loosed on earth is loosed in heaven. So how could I fail? I will not fail. I give thanks to God, who always causes me to be victorious and successful in Christ Jesus. My path is like the morning sun that shines ever brighter till the full light of day. I'm going from one level of glory to a higher level of glory. I'm going upwards and never backwards. This is my season of abundance. And God has given me the abundance mentality to unlock it in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. It will be inscribed on the very hearts of your people. We thank you, Lord, for the new thing that you're doing this year, that the old is behind and the new has come. And this is a new day for every person under the sound of my voice. In the name of Jesus, we give you all the honor and all the glory and all the praise for it. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Every head bowed and every eye closed. We can't leave a place like this without giving you the opportunity to say yes to Jesus. While every head is bowed, every eye closed, if you're not saved, you've not given your life to Jesus. We want to give you the opportunity to save the best for last. Saying, Pastor, I'm not saved. Or I don't have revival in my life. I'm not a vibrant Christian. I'm not on fire for God. I want to repent. I want to start over. I want to begin again. I want to turn over my life to Jesus. I want to turn over the driver's seat of my life and make Jesus the leader of my life. If that's you, here's what's going to happen. I'm going to shout 1, 2, 3. And as soon as I shout 3, I want you to lift up your hand in the air and say, Pastor, I want to be saved today. Pastor, I want to be part of this prayer today. I want to say yes to God in 2024. I want to live for God. If that's you, as soon as I shout 3, lift up your hand, and I'll be glad to pray with you. You will be the first fruits of 2024. You'll be the first fruits of 2024. Come on, I'm getting ready to count. If that's you, I want to be saved. I want to start this place. Amen. I want to take a moment and appreciate this incredible team standing on this stage. Help me celebrate Andrea there, our music director Chris here, who leads our worship teams, Lewis on that stage, production, so many people, Dave standing there in security. Please help me celebrate these young people. Larry back there, Rachel and Leah. Help me celebrate everybody that's made this happen. And then also, please help me celebrate all the leaders of Impact Church there, here in the front. I'm not going to mention names on TikTok. Help me celebrate our leaders a little more. What a God, what a church, what a people. Amen. Now, help me celebrate everybody that came tonight. But there's only one who deserves all the praise, the glory, and the honor. I need one more shout in the band, in the music, as we go. God bless you. 2024, the year to maximize. We'll see you on Sunday. God bless you.